If you keenly observe weather reports on the news, different aspects of weather patterns may stand out and pique your curiosity. Air humidity is mentioned countless times in weather reports, though sometimes it's just called humidity. This metric can also be expressed in percentages, so a weatherman might say, "The humidity is 78% today." You may also have noticed that the humidity value is sometimes 100%. Wouldn't that mean that the air has become water? Humidity, in simple words, is the measure of how wet the air is in a given place. More specifically, humidity is the amount of water vapor present in the air. Water vapor is the gaseous state of water, so it's not visible to the naked eye. People often complain about an uncomfortable day by saying, "It's not the heat, it's the humidity," when describing their city or environment. This is because a higher concentration of water vapor in the air can make hot temperatures feel even more unpleasant. It's important to note that humidity is actually an umbrella term that refers to three primary kinds of humidity: absolute humidity, relative humidity, and specific humidity. Absolute humidity is the measure of the total mass of water vapor in a given volume of air. Mathematically, absolute humidity can be calculated by dividing the volume of the air and water vapor mixture. However, the calculation of absolute humidity does not account for the temperature of the system. The value of absolute humidity is affected by changes in the air temperature or pressure changes. Specific humidity, on the other hand, is the ratio of the mass of water vapor to the total mass of the moist air parcel. This metric is informally referred to as the moisture content. Relative humidity, as the name suggests, is relative in nature. Basically, it's the amount of water vapor present in the air relative to what the air can hold. Relative humidity is generally expressed in percentages, as mentioned earlier. If a weather report shows the relative humidity to be 78%, it means that for the given temperature, the air is holding 78% of what it can actually hold. Think of it this way. If you have a glass of water that is half full of water, you would say that the glass contains 50% of what it can potentially hold. The concept of relative humidity is the same. Now, if the weather report shows the value of the relative humidity to be 100%, it doesn't mean that the air has become water. Rather, it means that additional moisture cannot enter the air and must remain as water. Fog is a good indicator of 100% humidity in a given area. A sponge that is 100% saturated with water doesn't become water itself. Similarly, a relative humidity of 100% doesn't mean that the air has turned into water, so you can leave your scuba gear at home.